Hi, this is Barbara from LiveBinders, and today I want to talk to you a little bit about table of contents and the overview page. So when you're building your binder, you're gathering all these great resources for people, but what you don't want is for people to open up your binder and just come to this blank page. That doesn't really give them an overview of what they're looking at. So we have an overview page that you can optionally add. And what it does is it takes the binder title and puts it up here, and it takes your binder cover picture and puts it right here, the author's name. And then this is your binder description. And you can see here they put a nice description here that gives a nice overview of what the binder is. So that is a great way to have the overview tab as the first thing that people see when they open your binder. So the other option is to have a table of contents, and this is what we put up by default. So similar, it has the binder title at the top and the binder description and then a little thumbnail of your binder cover. And then it's got a whole table of contents here so people can quickly get an idea of everything that's in this binder. So that's another alternative. You may feel that this is a little more overwhelming than the overview page, so it's really up to you which one you want to use. So let me show you how to add those to your binder or change those settings. So go into your binder in edit mode, click on settings, and then click on layout. And here you'll see in this binder I don't have an overview tab, but I can put it in the first or the second tab. And in this binder, I have a table of contents and it's in the first tab. And I can say none or first or second tab. The other thing, if you have a subscription, you can actually have a table of contents but remove that little information panel on the side. So if you want your overview to be in the first and then just a clean table of contents without the summary information on the left, you can remove that panel. So that's it. I recommend you use either an overview or a table of contents in your binder. Some people create their own overview pages, which are really nice too. Here's one where she added her cover to the left side and then just gave a little overview here. So that's another way to do it as well. But I do recommend that you put something in that very first tab, so that people understand what your binder's about.